Uh-oh. For the win right there. Boom. There's a replay. Good game, guys. Damn it.
Okay. I don't know how that works.
All right, I'll do one.
I couldn't even tell who had the I couldn't even tell who had it, to be honest.
I didn't know either. I just motion buttons. Oh, you bastard.
That'll work. Nice.
Whoops. That's not good.
Oh my god, wow. Okay. Oh, that's good.
I'm gonna make him throw that. Nice! It was to waste our time opening Discord and seeing a new message and all that, yeah.
Oh man, the wheels are coming off on that side at this point.
Here we go. What the hell?
Oh my lord. That was all you. Oh, that was, whoa. That thing was way short.
Oh, no.
That would have been hilarious. Slow. That guy's not throwing it to the middle. He's not throwing it in the middle. Neither is he. He's not throwing it in the middle either. Oh my god, man.
Oh my god.
Don't start crying. Don't start crying, man.
Keep it together,
man. Oh my god, he's so ready. He's not going in the middle.
Okay, voting's working. Get in there. Oh, I stuffed that. Oh shit. Oh, I love when I do that. Shit, I meant to pass. Good catch here, cause I... Oh, I got so lucky!
Physical game.
Oh my gosh.
Nice, got that one in there.
What?
Oh, oh my god,
what a save.
God, what a throw that was.
A throw.
That was a good throw.
Oh my gosh.
Oh my god, I thought I was having to die for it.
There we go.
Oh my god, you knocked one of them down and stuff. Oh, that's harsh.
Oh shit! Curved it right back at him. Oh, I'm feeling it tonight. Oh, it's close. Oh my gosh. Woo, that was close.
Whoops.
Nice.
Oh, that's nasty right there.
Oh, yeah.
Oh my god, that was a good throw. Oh my god, what a throw.
so close. Looked like he was almost there. Nice. And a good return. What a risk that Kells took right there. Charge. No! No! Oh, I got it! I got it! Oh my gosh! That was a good one. Oh, there's another good one. That was a good volley right there. I lost my... I'm gonna slip for that. Oh!
Nice block. That was great.
Thank you.
Gosh, him and it on the that should never happen. Give him quick turn, more guys got it. Gonna be crushed for this one. Donan's gonna pop super on. Gonna run as far forward as he can. More guys counter supers it. Now he's always super back. What a series! Oh my gosh, and boom is not working. Boom needs to be working.
Their minds. There's so much dust kicked up on the court, I can't see.
Nice grab by Frolic Man on a short hop. Oh, guys, pushed all the way up into the mid half.
Oh, no. Wow.
What a rally. What a rally. That was.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Friday Night Jams. And now your host, the one and only, Dr. Whistler. Friday Night Jams is not funded or officially supported by High Horse Entertainment or Disc Jam. It is a show run solely by Dr. Whistler. All opinions and statements do not reflect the creators of the game and should not be treated as opinions of the developers.
Hello. Man, how's the sound coming through for you guys? Because I'm having issues on my end. Sound is horrible. And problems with my headphones. Yeah, props to Compton for that little intro. Thank you, Compton. That was kind of neat. Hey, Fish. My voice sounds okay? The intro was fine. Thank you for the host there, Fish. All right. So, man, we got a lot of people ready to go tonight. I was going to go through a bit of a year in review, closing out what I'm calling season one of Friday Night Jams. Wanted to give some shout outs to you guys, to the show some stats. Stuff like that, and then maybe a little, show you a little bit about what I'm working on next for next year, and we can even maybe test it out a bit or jump right into Friday Night Jams if that's what you guys want to do. Let me get Q in here because I'm sure he's going to want to have. Chime in on some things. Discord real quick. Alright. So I'm in. 6 months subscribe or subscription. Love. Thanks, Q. You. I'm sorry, I was talking while you were. What was that? Hang on. What did you say? I'm gonna replay that again. What a fun first season. Let's review. Yes, let's review.
What's up?
Hey.
Yep, it was so much fun. So much fun this year.
I wanted to turn off. There we go. So, just to recap a bit, I went back looking. We purchased this game back in February.
Really? It's been February?
It's been since February. And at first, it was just. You know, you, me, kid, playing a lot of doubles, singles against each other, and mostly doubles in a queue. And it seemed like we started streaming Friday Night Jams about May-ish, June-ish. right in there. Remember,
that sounds about right.
Long queue times, and we were thinking, man, if we can get the community to come out at least one night a week, everybody getting the queues, we can get a lot more matches in a shorter period of time. It was a lot of fun. And I think I just called it Friday Night Jams. And then 6 weeks later, after that, we started, we set up this King of the Court. You know, intention there was just to promote further interaction with all you viewers and players. And this whole time it was supposed to be, you know, casual, fun, open to everybody. I didn't want it to be, you know, overly competitive, and I don't think it ever was. I think everybody mostly had fun. I don't think we ever had any issues in chat or anything. Then after that, we started with tracking season or session and lifetime stats. Set up the profile system. And we also saw a lot of support from other streamers. I want to give a shout out to Dan Vincent. Dan and his, you know, now he's doing the Dan V Open. He was streaming Disc Jam before I was. And remember Ram Sam Bam got his Disc Jam Arena going. And still that Talking Gator was probably the highlight. Get out of this background. Has anybody seen the Talking Gator?
Has anybody not seen the Talking Gator?
Who has not seen the
that
Talking Gator?
Hilarious.
Let me, let's watch that real quick here. Why are they getting moved?
Hi, Jammers, and welcome to Disc Jam Arena. My name is Gator, the bad guy with moustache. Did you know me and my friends organize a quick tournée every day? The incredible Daily Hero Tournée. Are you ready for pain? Join our Discord channel for more details. Disc Jam Arena.
That runs long. But that was... that was hilarious. But yeah, Ram Sam Bam with his Disc Jam Arena. Dan, big supporters. Appreciate you guys' support. Compton as well, bringing back Thursday Throwdown and giving his voice to, you know, the Bonk Command and throwing me ideas and the neat little intro he did for Friday Night Jams. I know also we had early on, I remember Ted Stryker, he throwing a bunch of tips out to me, aka Enrico. And what we got, I see a lot more people streaming lately. I know Q, you've been doing more. Is it Disc Jam Dojo's going? And I think Ted's got something going.
Yeah, I know Ted's been streaming. And yeah, Disc Jam Dojo sounds like they're getting going again on the weekends. So
I've been able to keep
up. Yeah, that's an amazing. Disc Jam Dojo coming back is awesome. Austin Dale Walrus and those guys getting that thing going again.
That's cool. Now let's fast forward a little bit to today. And we are at 25 plus weeks of Friday Night Jams, 20 weeks of King of the Court, and only 15 of the, I don't know why it says 15, only 15 of the 25 weeks keeping record, we've had 31 unique players enter the arena, 157 entries. We even had 13 players in the arena at one time, and we've played over 700 matches. That's just in the 15 of the 25 weeks. There's been a lot of matches played.
Wow, that's amazing. That is a lot. That's a lot of bringing people together. But those have been a lot of fun games. We've watched a lot of really good games on Friday Night Jams.
Not sure if I should have revealed this. You know, I might get a bill from Tim and Jay now, because I remember back early on they were talking about how there was like a cost to every lobby, every match.
Right.
Let's see. We've had, move on. What we got next? Next is you've had total of 70. Right one. Yeah, we've had a total of 77 hat tricks scored. And the most appearances so far, I've got them listed here. No name. I don't think has missed a night ever. He made, actually he hasn't. It's besides Q and I. We've had no names made every night. War guys right behind him. Autonomous, another big supporter. Shout out to you guys, especially Autonomous. He'd be here more if he didn't have to work so often on Fridays. Big Kel was an early supporter. He played a lot when we first got going. Compton and Particle Man. Q and I are kind of excluded, but he's up there. He's right behind No Name. He actually has 15. He missed one night. I think he was gone or...
Yeah, I was not feeling well. There was one night I wasn't feeling well, and I had to call it in sick. But I believe Fish was nice enough to help do play-by-play one time. And so shout out to Fish on that night. He was a hero for us.
Yeah. So like, I wanted to throw out some names here. These are the players that have played since I've been keeping record, and I know there's been more. We have, see if you guys remember these names. Alex Powers. Anti-Distortion, Autonomous, Benji, aka Big Kells, Coin QT, Compton EMT, Dan Vincent, Dr. Fish, Dr. Grimm, Dolphin Finn, or Salty Dolphin, Hard Drop Texas, Julio Rolio, Little Only, aka Swarmy, MJ Nance, Monster, Nico Luna, Particle Man, Q-Sec, QT, Palpitations, Queens Dude 18, Ram Sam Bam, Skylos, Tempa, Ted Stryker, aka Enrico, aka Stanley Roper. He's had several names. The C-Max guy, the Gamer Kid, Too Much Mustard, No Name, We Die, War Guy, Wyatt Cordell, Feeder Castro, Untubular, Rexus, XG Sweet, and most recently, Shiny Magikarp. Well, that's quite a list there. And I know there was more. I wasn't keeping track from the very, very beginning.
Yeah, we brought some. We saw a lot of players from the time that we started that came back to the game that had walked away. And that's a lot of those names on the list. But we saw a handful of people that had just started playing the game too. So trying to expand out the player base. A couple of different ways as the weeks have gone by. So it's been awesome that there's been a place where they, you know, everybody always knows where they can get together. They always know that on Friday nights there's going to be good games in one spot.
Jump is another name. Yeah. That wasn't on list. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So not only we have, it seemed like every week we've always had somebody new jump in, new to the game or just new to the stream. They'll jump in. Like you said, old players coming back. Also, we've had players from around the globe. We, you know, Shiny Magikarp from Japan last week. We've got people I see that have Oceanic, like from the Oceanic region, based on their profile that they set up. And then, of course, everybody in, you know, EU, which is harder for you guys to join during this time, I understand. I thought that was pretty neat. Next, I wanted to give a big shout. I don't know if No Name is here yet. I haven't seen him pop his name in, but if he's around, you got to check out these results he's got. Oop. Let me back up. I'm on the wrong one. There he is. most appearances. What is going on with all these? There we go. Got something out of order here. But player of the year here. I want to give a shout out to No Name. 36 hat tricks, 113 wins, only 4 losses, 97 winning percentage. That's just through 15 weeks. And he's been here from the beginning. So he's played a lot more than that. runner up. Is War Guy. And he has 10 hat tricks, 38 victories, 15 losses, a 72 winning percentage. So, and War Guy is a great player. Was like number one. These guys like number one, number two on the singles. I know at one point. So congrats to War Guy. You've been around a long time as well. Appreciate your support. Wanted to show you guys who the hat trick leaders were. No Name with his 36. War Guy with his 10. Big Kells with his 7. He was racking up a lot of them. He hadn't been playing as much lately, but in the beginning he was. And he had more than that before he even started tracking. Particle Man. And here are the rest. Everybody on this list has earned, you know, a hat trick. At least one for a Night Jams. And that hat trick is, you know, winning 3 in a row. So congratulations to you guys. No, Dr. Whistler, I did not get one. I didn't get one in my own game, huh? In my own stream. So some updates with the patch coming out. New skins are now available for your profile. I have changed the profile system. We'll get that here in a second. Not yet, maybe tonight. Dan. I got the new skins. You can now set your preferred court. Now everybody's gonna want to play penthouse. That's fine. That's the default. But eventually, when you get tired of the new court, you can set your preferred court. If yours matches your opponent, that's the one I'll create the match in. Okay. I did set up a new profile system. I had to do this for stuff I'm working on next. So. For tonight, the king of the court is still going to run off the profiles using the KOTC space profile command. All right. But moving on after tonight, you're just going to use, we're going to have one central profile. It's going to work for all different game modes that we'll be creating. So just use the profile command. I shortened it up just a bit. So you can set your region, your court, your main skin, and your skill rating. This is your singles skill rating. You know, everybody's been great. I feel like everybody's been really honest. They haven't been, you know, trying to enter and exit the queue, and trying to, but everybody's been pretty honest and just, and fair. And, so if everybody can put in their skill rating, this is going to come handy and I'll show you here in a bit. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and give you a hint into what's coming up next. I'm working on something called Mortal Jam. Might have heard it. Q's mentioned it in his stream, and I might have mentioned it in the update for tonight's stream. So, Q, you still there?
Yep, and all yep. I know is the name. So you have done an excellent job of keeping everyone in suspense on how this Mortal Jam is going to work.
Okay,
so I'm all ears. All
right, here we'll see if it works out or not. But what I've noticed is that we've got our set players that, you know, that come back week to week, and, you know, we got skilled players come back every week. I wanted to somehow get these new players, the lesser skill players, to come in and stay in and come in week to week. That's one thing I wanted to accomplish. Another thing I wanted to do at the same time was offer maybe a new challenge for you guys, other than just trying to win 3 in a row and playing the same guys every week. So I came up with this idea that we are going to kind of model this off of like Mortal Kombat. We're going to generate a challenge tower, and a challenger, and you're going to go in the, based on the SR, I got all this coded already, really. We'll pull names from the arena and populate the challenge tower based on your skill rating. The intent or the goal here is to like get the first, maybe it's a 3 or 5 player tower, and the challenger will start off playing somebody that's maybe a little lower skill than them at the start, and then as they rise up the tower, they will go against the higher skill players. Okay, and we're going to have a separate point system. As you win each round, you're going to accrue points, and we'll have a leaderboard. So just a different incentive. So I don't know if that is that giving you questions there,
that,
Q?
No, I don't. That sounds really, really interesting. So if it's a 3 or 4 or 5 person tower, so okay, all right. No, I'm
so
with, that
let
seems
me,
pretty. That, that
I'll give you a bit of a
clear.
Visual. I don't have the that overlays seems, done yet, but let me give you a visual, and let me switch scenes real quick, and let's go. Let's go over here. Okay. Again, the overlays aren't done. This is very just generic stuff. So we've got a little bit of tower on the right side. This is a 5 challenge tower. And the little box here on the at the bottom is the challenger. Now, I can draw this completely random. If everybody types in MJ space enter, you will enter the Mortal Jam arena. We get names in here.
All right, well, we've got some people willing to give it a go here.
Okay, as soon as it pauses for a second, I'm going to take out a couple people.
Okay, this is doing right now is it's putting you into this game, this Mortal Jam arena, right? And yeah. We haven't chosen who the combatant is going to be.
Correct.
The primary combatant is going to be, nor have we, and obviously without that, we can't pick the opponents. So, okay.
Right. At this point, we just have, you viewers, players, or are in the Mortal Jam arena. Okay, so it's quieted down. Let me get in here real quick. I had some test users I want to get out of the arena. So we got myself, Fish, MJ Nance, Test Striker Q, Dan Vincent, Autonomous, No Name, some names I see. So right now, we can do a total random drawing.
Okay.
So if I do...
So will the random drawing still stack the skill ratings up, or will it? Is it ran? Is the order random in the tower?
I get to... I'm just checking in. Well, I might have to do it myself. So let me go. All right, ask your question again, Q.
Oh, I was just asking. So if you do a random, is it going to randomly place the people in the tower, or does it still balance it, by skill going up?
Right. So it will balance by skill going up. So I can randomly select the challenger first, and then the challenged will be selected mm-hmm. and ordered by their skill rating.
Okay.
We can also choose the challenger, who the challenger is. I can set the challenger, and then we can build a random tower off that, or I can set it all completely.
Gotcha. Okay.
Right. Intent is, and then we know all the top players mostly, so we can also swap players around. Once we see the tower generated, we can just kind of eyeball it and say, all right, let's switch a couple of people around here and then go.
Oh, okay. Cool.
Okay. Because with the way King of the Court's working, it's kind of just order by whoever joins.
Mm-hmm.
When you join the arena,
you might get stuck behind somebody and, you know, playing the same person over and over, or not get that opportunity to play someone closer to your skill. You get, might get bumped, you know, matched against
right.
a new guy, like last week, could have get matched against No Name. So trying to generate something here that can...
Sure. No, it's, I think it's a great idea. I think that's a great idea. So if you see players like Gamer Kid get in, if he picks it back up and starts showing up again, then him and you and Skylos, you know, those, right. that might be the types of players he gets to run against.
Right.
Yeah. I think that'll be really, I think that'll be really helpful for newer players. Yeah.
Okay. So let me updates.
And at the end of the day, it'll, I think it'll provide better, better matches to watch too. I mean, we'll just get better on stream matches.
Yeah.
And still gives people the opportunity to know when they're going to play, if they got a match coming up, you know, because once that ladder gets drawn, once the tower gets built, you kind of know who's in, you know, hey, you know what? I'm not going to be up for a few minutes. I can queue into singles queue, you know, or whatever. Right. So it really does check a lot of the boxes I think that we wanted to have, that we yeah. that we liked about Friday Night Jams, while really helping out the skill level and really adjusting it to the skill level of the player. So that'll yeah. be awesome. This is a great idea.
Okay, so then I populated the challenge tower, so what it looks like, a little bit. I had to put my mm-hmm. test users back in because apparently I got something to fix. This is still a work in progress. And, you know, so, you know, if we realize test one at the top should be at the bottom of the tower and test two at the top, I can just do a quick swap. Now we're also going to do a point system. And so each round is worth different number of points. And, also, we'll keep a leaderboard and you'll get points for as you, and win each round and move up the challenge tower.
So do you mean, so if I get 1 point for, so I'm using the tower that's up on the screen right now, right? If I'm the Haruka player and I beat the test two player, I get a point. Now, yeah. if I beat test four, do I get like 2 points or do I get 1.5
right.
points?
So I'm thinking like 10 points for round one, 25 points okay. round two, 50 points round three, 75 round four, 100 round five.
Gotcha. Okay.
Something like that. We can do like three challenge tower or five challenge tower. Just depends on how many people we have in the arena.
Gotcha.
Okay.
Gotcha.
And, but I also wanted to encourage the challenge. You guys are working as a team because you need to stop the challenger. All right. So you're going to be rooting for each other.
Right.
And there's points that you guys can earn as well, or the viewers. So you can, I'm going to set it up where you can vote similar to how you vote for red or blue. You know, in Disc Jam for a winner, you can vote for the challenger or the challenged, and if you vote correctly, you can get yourself some additional points, so you can help yourself move up the leaderboard, even though you're not the one playing yet.
Gotcha, gotcha.
Okay. I mean, that's the gist of it.
No, that sounds awesome. I think that'll be a lot of fun. That's a great idea.
And that's it. So it's going to be probably another week or two and some testing. So we might do some Wednesday night tests. I'll make sure to announce that and work out some bugs.
Yeah, that's a good question, Fish. I don't know. What do you? I'm assuming it'll be best of one, the way that we've always done Friday Night Jams. But I guess that's up to us. Are we going to do best of three within each one of these matches? They might get kind of long. A tower would get kind of long if there's best of three.
That was something else I was thinking, because I really didn't want to. You know, a five challenge tower can be long. It's going to be just one match. Okay. Hang on.
Yeah, I think a best of one is probably makes the most sense.
And we'll play with it, because initially I thought, well, maybe two out of three, but with a few caveats, I was thinking if the challenger jams his opponent on the very first set, he's an automatic win, and he moves up to round two, and he gets double points. So round one.
Or Or you could just do one set to 6 points. Boom, the games go fast.
Right.
Sudden death every game. Or not, you know, I'm just something like that.
So if you can, there's some incentives. So like,
yeah,
you know, a better skilled player can go for some extra points. He goes, man, I'm gonna hunker down and try to jam this first set, get double bonus points, move on to round two. If the challenger wins the first set, or I'm sorry, the first match, he automatically moves up. But the challenged, he has to win two out of three. To knock the challenger out,
mm-hmm.
something like that. But we'll see how quickly it goes. But it's going to be a point system with the leaderboard, and like you said, try to get the challenger through the first round or two quickly, so he gets up against a tougher challenge.
Mm-hmm. Makes sense. Yeah, that's something we can look at doing. If, like I said, if they get jammed or something, we can look at that. Just kind of see, get a feel for how that works.
Mm-hmm.
Well, all right. That sounds awesome.
That's all I had. So, again.
Oh, yeah, that's all? That's it? Only a completely new game mode? Okay. Wow, that sounds like that'll be great.
Is it going to be a busy night?
I don't know. Who's all in? I haven't looked.
Oh, let me throw up.
We got five in the court right now, so
yeah,
pretty average at this point. I mean, this is at this point in Friday Night Jams. That's about what we normally.
Yeah, we I think I read calculated we average about eight. We've averaged eight jammers in the arena.
Oh, really? That really that high?
Yeah. Yeah,
remember, wow.
Early on we had double digits almost weekly.
Mm-hmm.
So if you guys are up for it, we can get some King of the Court for fun going tonight. The Mortal Jam's not ready.
Yeah, Mortal Jam's thinks it's all over the board, though. It thinks it's ready.
Yeah, it thinks it's ready.
That will be a lot of fun. I'm really looking forward to seeing how that feels. And Ignite with live games and everything.
All right.
I really think the idea of having that, especially because if you jam your opponent in the first round, and then that jumps you out of that matchup and just moves it, that would make it move a lot faster too. If we think it's kind of slogging along.
Yeah.
And I guess, like you said, we could always make it a three-person tower if we feel like it's.
Yep.
If we're not getting good games.
Thanks, Dan.
That's awesome.
Well, I just thought, you know, for the lesser skill players that come in, let's get them matched up with someone they can play with, which usually me, because I'm not that good. I spend more time trying to create stuff than playing the game lately.
Well, we appreciate your sacrifice.
Ish, when was the last time you played this jam? I don't know if you've been playing much. Or actually, maybe I had. I was looking at the leaderboard, and I see a lot of new names up there in the top 10, top 15.
What was that? No, you broke up on me. I didn't catch it.
Oh, I was asking Dr. Fish if he had been playing much
lately. Oh.
This week I have. I'm 25th. He's climbing back up the board. Got some awesomes.
Whistler's
if you ask bad. Compton, I'm really good at throwing down the sidelines.
Well, if you ask Compton, I'm really good at throwing it over the middle. So, between the two of us, we're set.
Anyway, it's been fun, and what I'm really enjoying out of it is I'm learning all kinds of new stuff. I'm programming in Python, playing around with video editing, photoshopping, and 2D stuff. I mean, that stuff, I like to get into that kind of stuff.
So you're a nerd.
Yeah, and you guys coming out and playing Disc Jam with me and letting me, you know, do this a lot of fun. I appreciate it.
It's been an absolute joy to be a part of it as you've put it all together. You've done all the heavy lifting on this whole thing. So it's been great just to be a part of it.
I forgot two people. I need to give a big shout out to Tim and Jay, the developers for this game, and I've hit them up a couple times asking, hey, is what I'm doing okay? Because, you know, I'm photoshopping their characters. You know, I'm like, let me know if I'm doing anything I shouldn't. But I'm glad they got this patch out too. That's fun. I like it.
Yep. Yeah, they got some adjustments to it, and they got some kinks to work out. But it's nice to see some stuff actually come out. Okay.
Lobby is open. If Fish and Q want to jump in.
I will be getting in. I'm going to go ahead and mute my mic so you don't hear me yelling.
All right. I better go spectator here. Dr. Fish is back in the arena. We haven't seen him for a few weeks. We Die says, I don't think I've seen this format yet, huh? Yeah, I have to go back and look and see the last time you joined us on Friday Night Jams. Yeah, Autonomous. Let me know when you're ready for that. So don't forget to get your votes in. We Die. We actually have a bunch of new commands. You go jump out into my Discord channel. I got everything laid out there. But there's a jam. What is it? Jam stuff. Bonk. There's another, you can clap. Yeah, you just call out who you want your opponent to be, Autonomous. And we'll pull you in. Bonk without the space. Exclamation point, bonk. No space. Nintendo Switch. That's the one. Who took the first set here? Got two picks red, one pick blue. Looks like Fish. Fish is out to a 16-0 lead on the second set. Playing strong with Gator. Oh, that was a good throw by Q. Cut him back on Fish. MJ Nance, he's got it. Gator, I don't have the new skins.
Get bonked, son!
The new skins will be there next week. I do have them created. They are, I didn't have them ready for King of the Court. I had them ready for Mortal Jam. Founder skins are available upon request. You just have to show me you know, screenshot or something in game that you actually have the skin. For tonight, still have to use the KOTC. The KOTC space set main command or king of the court. The new exclamation point profile system is for Mortal Jams, but I'll get them both. We'll still have king of the court. We're gonna have Mortal Jam, and I'll eventually get them both on the same, you know, one profile system. There you go. Looks like Q did come back and take that second set. Oh man, that looked like it went right through Fish's hands. Thought he had it. Ace. After all that work by Fish to catch up, gives up the ace. All right, pretty much tied up. Coming down to the end here. Oh, it was a great read by Q. He anticipated correctly. But I'm not sure how it's... I don't know if he was just a little late or too soon. This could go Fish's way here. Just needs one more volley for Fish. He got greedy. Oh, that was, I thought he was gonna short hop it. What a game. Congratulations, Fish.
Yeah, that was a good one to get started with, I think. That's a close one.
Let's go back. Didn't do it again.
Is it advancing?
I'll do it just a second. Try again here. There we go. Sometimes it just doesn't want to do it. And then the rest of time it does. I don't know. All right. Dr. Fish. He's still in. Versus Ted Stryker. Welcome back, Ted. Oh, thanks, Weed Eye. The wife disagrees, though.
They always disagree, okay?
DRW1. How many jammers do we have in the arena? Six? Oh. Wee Dice says it's been a few months. I wonder if he's seen the kiss cam yet.
I don't know if we had it back then or not. I thought we did. I don't know. I guess we'll see. The kiss cam came after the, well, after the, what, how much?
Uh-oh, Wee Dice much, says he's not seen the kiss cam.
Oh, so better make sure he's got his profile set up.
I think, did you set your profile, Wee Dice?
To get your preferred main character and skin.
I'm going back through. I thought he was messing with it. That's all right. He'll have.
Yeah, he'll want to get that going. You don't think so?
Well, he's okay. Got your Stanton Disc Jam by default. Let's do one more. Let's get Fish. He's all warmed up.
Yep. Let's get this guy. Let's get this game going.
We get to Spectator. I'm assuming Penthouse. I'll confirm Penthouse and. Let's do this. Let me shout out. There, I just gave a shout out in chat on how to do the profile.
All right, well, here we go. We've got Enrico Palazzo / Ted Stryker in blue and Dr. Fish in red. So we're going to open up with a couple of nice field throws. There's a skinny hop that gets right in on the post. Fish with a nice throw there. Rico with the defensive slide sending back out of the end zone. He couldn't get to it. And there, wow, another nice little skinny hop. A little harder this time, but it worked. Got in front of Enrico, and he's up 14-0. And another one that curves right in front of Enrico, and he just looks like he's just kind of just misjudging the speed of the character or the disc and just coming up a little bit short. See if he can tweak that going forward and get it back into this one. But he's down 20-0 to start. Well, that's one good rally, but Fish is now juiced with 12 on the rally, and he's going to get those 12 points, 32-0. It's all Fish right now. Rico Plaza is kind of just running around having to play defensively. So still getting going, I think, he is with his movement. So we'll see what he can do from now on. So he's going to slide, throw in a couple of these, sliding a little bit. Fish is going to get juiced. He's going to slap on that short lob, quick curve. Plaza's got it. And lob him to the back. Post shot. It hit the third panel. Rico gets that pretty easily. Nice field throw. Forces Fish to slide. Another one off the third panel. And another really good field throw. Fish has to slide for that. He's going to cut off that post throw. Rico cuts off that. His post return throw. And now they're going back and forth. They've got 23 on the rally. And this one's going to be a big one. It's a nice wall skip. And Rico's going to slide through that. He answers the zone. But it's a blue third panel shot again. And Rico gets to it pretty easily. There's that short hop. There it is. There he goes. Sorry, not short up. There's that skinny hop that he bit him on earlier in the match. He went right back to it there. Takes a big rally. Go into it with a finish off a big jam.
There's a jam. Somebody get the jam command out.
Yep. So Enrico's going to get lobbed underneath this in the back here. There's a skinny hop. Short hop. Enrico going to run up on this and keep his juice and put him in a little bit more aggressive position. A nice filth throw going back the other direction. Now he's on the board 11-0. He's going to open up the serve, going to get Rico to slide on the pole. He's going to pull. Oh, Rico's going to go to the net on aggro wall skip. It's a blue one, though. He gets underneath this lob, didn't get locked on. So we've seen some of that going on with this new update. Net field throw, but Dr. Fish cuts it off. He was kind of ready for that. Blue throw. It's a blue throw. It's a nice field throw. It's perfect. Right off the back of the first panel into the post.
I like that and disc.
Yeah, the
that's
bossy
my favorite disc.
Bossy disc is pretty popular. That was a really nice throw by Palazzo and Enrico. Even though it was blue, he got it by him. But Fish comes back, getting recovers a few of those points. And now they're kind of back going at it again. That's a nice post shot. There's another field throw. Enrico's field throws are starting to tighten up a little bit. He's starting to look pretty good with them. Nice slide through there. He has to slide because he was juiced. Now there's another one. That does force Fish to slide. You've seen Enrico really get his throws going. There's the Zed. And he's going to take these points. And that's the difference now. Enrico's throws are getting on. He's forcing Fish to slide on some of these fills. His fills are so good right now. There's another good blue fill. He's going to get another slide. He's going to get lobbed to the back. There's a short hop. Fish slides for that. He answers his own short hop, but it goes right down the middle. It's a white, but a good post shot. Forces Fish to slide. There's another good fill, but we shield reach on Fish. He gets it. Slide through, skinny hop. Oh, a pocket shot, but Rico Plaza slides through on it. There's a hop throw. Rico's got that. Fish is juiced, but he loses. They've got 22 points going to be on this rally. This is going to be a big one. Of course, Enrico's going to win if he gets it. And if Fish can manage to pull this one out, it's going to be basically tied. And it is basically tied. So this one's going to go right down to the wire. What a nice rally that was. Dr. Fish did a great job of just staying in that one. And really, both guys kind of ebbed and flowed on that one. Each one of them kind of had the advantage for a little bit. And
Got,
puts himself right on 49, though.
So close.
So all Enrico's got to do is win this one any minute now. And that, as of now, that's a jam point. So whoever takes this one is going to win. So Fish is juiced, but he has to slide for that really nice blue field throw. There's a hard hop throw out of Palazzo. Fish thrown again, and there's that skinny hop.
That's a nice throw.
So that skinny hop is really working for Fish in that match overall. Really saw that when Enrico could throw his could catch the disc and throw it the way he wanted, he was getting really good feels and forcing Fish. But now, Fish could get his feet underneath the disc and throw where he wanted. Juice, when he went to that skinny hop, for that really it was working for field throw. There's a hard
what
hop.
A great match.
Another good match to start off the night. Fish thrown again, and there's that skinny hop.
Fish is on a roll.
He is. That skinny hop is really
might have to update the hat trick numbers.
Might have to have a last-second alteration.
Hang on. Aren't the players showing up? Something's... Players...
The old system knows it's on the way out, and so it's protesting.
Yeah. Protesting.
This is like the dude's last day when he knows it's his last day at work. If that's what your scripts are doing that now. They're like, what are you going to do? What are you going to do if it don't work? Yeah, what a great game. Yep. Q-Sec on the mic, Autonomous. You know it. Almost always. I'll try to get here every week.
Oh. Dang it. I hate this.
So, yes, that was a really great run. Fish is looking pretty sharp right now. Both Q-Sec, who he just beat. In the first match, and Enrico Palazzo, both ranked higher than him on the leaderboards. So Fish has always been a very good technically sound player. He knows where he wants to be. He knows what he wants to do. And when his execution is on, he's as good as anybody that plays this game. I think the question's always been, with him, consistency, playing consistently. He takes breaks. He steps away. He comes back. And he has to shake off the rust. But whenever he's playing and he's warmed up and on with his execution, he is as good as anybody that plays this game.
Welcome, Particle Man. Particle Man has entered the arena.
Hey, P-Man. Good to see you again.
All right, let's get this next one going. Dr. Fish going for the hat trick. I always got to go through No Name.
He does have his hands full with No Name. No Name, again, also a excellent disc jam player. Currently ranked number one on the leaderboard. And, the career hat trick leader in Friday Night Jams by a large margin. So this is going to be a test for Fish. But his first two matches weren't pushovers either, and he got through them. So he's got some momentum going. He's got momentum on his side. This DRW2.
Yeah, DRW2. I don't know why. Scripts.
So let me get the spectator.
Oh.
And I apologize. I may need to take a break after this match. I may need to take an extended break.
Okay. No problem.
But
if anybody wants to jump in and play by play, let me know. Jump into the Discord.
Start warming up those pipes during this match. In fact, Fish might be one of those people that might be interested. So, but if there's anybody else out there that would be interested in play-by-play, speak up. And I might step aside for a few matches, or two matches, or three matches, and hand the mic over to somebody else.
All right, let's start this one. Fish versus No Name. Fish going for the hat trick.
All right, so... let's see what we can get. Wait for my screen to update. Give me the screen. There we go. No Name in blue. Fish in red. Let's try to throw down the sideline. We didn't see a lot of sideline throws in the previous match. We saw skinny hops and we saw nice fills. Not a lot of straight throws down the sideline. So I'm interested to see what we get out of this. No Name with the quick curve right at the net. Playing with Lanny now.
Nice short hop, bro. A little bit of a hiccup on my screen, so I don't know if I had a little bit of lag on that. But it looked like a really nice short hop that just managed to get in front of Fish. There's a blue down the sideline. Phil throw. No name cuts it off the slide. Blue post shot. Fish is juiced now, but he's going to throw wall skip that blue right into a super saw blade. He does get to it. Forces No Name to slide on a really nice return throw. And now they're both building juice again. We got 16 on the rally. We pop this one up, go to center, it's a wall skip. Now No Name is juiced. Fish has to slide for that throw. Post shot into the second panel and can't quite reach this juice throw. And that's gonna give some points to No Name. That was actually a pretty good starting rally, I thought. Or a second rally for the players. Now there Fish just went hard in the net and got bit. So a little bit of miscalculation maybe there. Maybe he thought he saw something that he thought he could exploit, but looks like they're back playing regular here. Short hop, bounces around. That's a nice wall skip. This purple, and No Name gets caught in a hoppy zone. And yep, that one skims right by him, really close. That top down replay is so good for stuff. It's awesome. I love it. Oh, and Dr. Fish was in the right spot, and he just slid right out of the way of the disc. Oh, sometimes that's the downside of trying to play that 50-50 games. Sometimes you guessed right, and. But you needed to stand where you were and not panic slide. So, it's what happens sometimes. It's a high risk, high reward game. And meanwhile, No Name going to his net, playing his style of aggro, finishes off that first set. There's a short hop. He's just going to pop this up in the middle of the court as hash would be. He's going to get a super return. So, still seeing a lot of supers out of No Name, even with the 100 millisecond adder. And wow, that's a great couple of counters on supers. And this rally is going to keep going, but No Name's juice is 16 on the clock, and that's going to be tough for Fish to get back to from that sidewall position. So there's another pull. No Name gets to its clean, and a lot. Fish to back, go right to the net, and now he's going to hard hop this over. It's a double slide to get to this. He does. He's going to blues on the second panel post shot. He's going to go another post shot, second panel. This just sneaks by No Name, so I think, I'm not sure why that one got by him, but it just snuck by him. I guess he thought he was going to get back to that, but he just pulled up a little too early. So 13-16 in the second set. Slide cut that one off in a nice skinny hop. That's going to put No Name up 23-13. So I see a No Name style change a little bit. It's not exactly like it used to be, but still a very aggressive positioning. I guess you would call it an aggro style, but it's just a super aggressive one. And that can be really tough to deal with. He's really working those shots to the center. When Fish tries to take it back over the center, he's right there to get it. So it looks like Fish can try to adjust. He threw a couple down the sideline this time. There's a quick curve from the net. No Name's in a good position for it. Post shot, No Name's also in a good position to catch that one clean. He's going to try to super this ricocheting short hop throw, and he messes up the super, and that's going to give up some points. 28-41, Fish trying to claw his way back into this, and he needs a set. And there's a super on this blue post shot that goes off the second panel. That's a super return. It's going to put No Name at 48. This is a straight throw off the pole. And slide on that one, and it's a skinny hop. The Fish has to slide for it. It's going to lob into the back. He's underneath it for another super, and there's the spiral, and that's going to finish it off. Nice game. That was a good game by Fish. He really challenged. He made him work for a lot of those points. That was a really good rally. They had some really good rallies.
I'm waiting on Compton's so greedy soundbite. I thought he was going to send me one. I'll have to hit him up again. The greedy, and then the block lobster would be a couple good ones. That was a good run, Fish.
Alrighty, yep. I thought you challenged it pretty well. I thought that was a back and forth. I thought it was a little bit closer than this showed. And when you haven't played No Name very much, he can surprise you.
Good stuff. Jansen, we'll go through the rotation once, and then we'll we'll mix it up.
I'm going to step aside for a few minutes. I will be back, but I'm going to go silent, and I will get back on here in a little bit. Thanks.
Okay. Well, Weedah hasn't seen this before, so let's all take look. Get over here. Everybody, I have look up at the Jumbotron here. I wonder what happened there. It didn't show your guys' image. What did it say? Windows Air. Great. We broke it right at the very end. Now what I need to do is get like one of those ketchup, mustard, and pickle races going, huh? All right, no name. Get this match going. Hey, where's Autonomous? Autonomous, you make sure you let me know when you're ready. I missed it. Room War Beyond, DRW3. DRW3 is reserving. Too much hotness. Yeah, DRW3 is open. Match settings. House. Oh, no name. Got it. Who's strong? Is that Nance? Is that you? Or is that someone else? That's you. Okay. Match is starting. Oh, that was a good... Was that a skinny hop? I like that one. Strong is on the board first. Oh, right outside the reach of Lanny. Look at that. Strong sitting on 21. What disc is this? I don't recognize this disc. What is that? I have not seen that one. Oh my gosh. It is. If I dare say, get your jam commands ready. We got one vote blue. Oh, there. Put the jam commands away. Oh no, two quick ones in no name. We saw no name go down, I think, down 40 something to nothing. I mean, it was high 40s, if I remember right. And he came roaring back to take it. He had almost got jammed. I think it was this last week. Oh my gosh, what a recovery. I thought that was getting by strong. That was a great defense. Oh, and the bonk! He had almost got jammed.
Get bonked, son!
There it is. Thank you, Fish. Oh my gosh, what a recovery. I thought that was getting by strong. And that wasn't enough to win the set. That was a great defense. Oh, and the bonk! No name. Down one set to none. I don't know if that was a little greedy on that one. It looked like it went right through his hands. What a save. Great angle by a Strong. Have a wall skip by Strong. Oh! Did not think he'd get there. No Name with full juice takes advantage. He's got his first lead of the match. Wow, Strong gets another one by Lanny. Uh-oh. No Name getting juiced. Need to get him to slide. Oh, so greedy. So greedy. That was a good throw. Great slide by, oh. Strong is just making all the right choices here. Perfect throws. He needs one more volley to pull off the upset here. Not gonna happen on this one, because No Name got full juice. Could be it right here. Either we're going three sets. Oh my gosh, what a save! What another save! Wow, what a series. From corner to corner, and then the aggressive play at the net by No Name to squeak out that win. Could be it right here. Either we're going three sets. Oh my gosh, what a save! What another save!
Bronx on the board first.
Wow. What a series. By a No Name read that from the immediately before it even hit that left wall and came over half court. Uh-oh. What a save. Strong sliding back to the baseline. Oh my gosh. That's a close one. No Name sitting there with a little bit of a lead, playing aggressive. Really getting aggressive with Lanny. That was a good job keeping it on the net. Whoa! Going down to the wire. Oh, he just kept it straight down. No Name stepped to the right, and it was just too much. One more volley for Strong. He just needs one. He's on the net. He's aggressive. And he jukes No Name. Wow. We need to... somebody needs to clap on that one. There we go. Wow. Great game. Congratulations there. Thanks. That is a very rare occurrence on Friday Jams. Well, you are still in, my friend. Great. We die says great. Good game, No Name. What are we at? DRW 4, West, US East, between Nance and Weedy. Don't jinx this. Okay, now who is Neon Japan? Is that Weedy? Change your name. Make sure that's you. I think one time at the very beginning we had somebody snipe a match, and I didn't realize it was not the intended opponent. That is Weedy. All right, Nance. Once you're done shaking off the nerves. Oh, he's in now. Match settings, penthouse, confirm. Points, sets to win. Oh, that's right, we can set those now. So that's gonna be even better for Mortal Jam. All right, let's roll. Now, there is no court that you can set in King of the Court, so I'm sorry to confuse you. Exclamation point profile, you can use that one to set your court, your SR. That will be the new one, hopefully starting next week. In fact, we might as well just plan on doing a Wednesday night test run of Mortal Jam. Needs to do some debugging. So if you guys want to come out Wednesday night for some matches, help me break the code, so I know what I need to fix. Appreciate it, Fish. Get your votes in. Hard not to want to vote red after that last match. A strong short hop, but Weedy was there. That one looks like it went right through Weedy's hands. Let's see, New Year's is on Tuesday, right? So Wednesday would be the day after New Year's. Oh yeah, it isn't New Year's. Okay, I misread your... Since it isn't New Year's. So the first set did go to the MJ Nance. Strong is full juiced. Oh great, now the bot's not working. Well, Strong looking to close this out. Oh, he threw it right at Weedy. Got some white throws, blue throws. Finally, a pink throw. That's enough to push it beyond 50 for red player. Congratulations there, Nance. Good game. That's two in a row for you now. Oh, there we go again. Come on. Well, Q's back up, but he ain't here. How's he back up? Am I not in the arena? Did I not enter? I'm in now. We'll skip Q. We'll put him back on deck. How about I play MJ Nance? Let me look and see what we have. Oh, Autonomous is ready. Okay, let's give Nance his hat trick, and then you and I will be up next, Autonomous. Or Autonomous, you and whichever opponent you wish. Well, actually, you know, Particle Man's up next. I'll let, I'm just going to skip Q and let Particle Man, you can win. You want, who do you want to challenge, Nance? If I had gotten in, it'd be me. Nah, I'll play you. It would have been me. I just forgot to get in, I think. Come on, bot. Oh, jeez. Well, the bot's just gone bonkers. So everybody hung on. The bot's going to spam. Going to spam everybody. Let's see where it ends. It's going bonkers. Everybody move back. It might blow up here. Wow, look at that. Man, this thing, I've never seen it do this before. I don't think it's going to stop. I think I'm going to kill it. It's not really doing anything. Wow. Kill him now. I killed it. That was a first. Yeah, I didn't actually do anything. All right, let me try this one more time. Oh, it's gonna do it again. All right, whatever. I'm opening up the room. What were we on? I don't know what's going on with the bot. Room number is DRW5. Yeah, thank you. Okay, it didn't want to do that. It's reserving now. Oh, you messed it up. I got in early and left. But you couldn't have gotten in early. Did you just, did you create it on accident? It's open now. There you go, Fish. Can you hear us? Can you talk?
Yeah. Yeah. Hi.
Aha. Uh-huh. How you doing?
Good, man. How are you?
Well, it could be better. My bot could be working.
Yeah, your bot could be working. That is a thing.
All right, I'm gonna get this going. All
right.
I haven't played since last week.
Oh, nice. So we have Whistler versus Dr. Whistler versus DRW's dead King of the Court bot, aka Nance. I'm probably just gonna call him Nance. So 10 points for Whistler to start. Nance with 9 points of his own. I can't get over that name. It's so fitting.
Hilarious.
Both guys loving going down the right side. Backlot from Whistler, cross court from Nance, down the line from Whistler, wall hop from Nance, wall hop back from her, wall rides back, and then Nance with the short hop gets the points, 27 to the 10. That's a stuff block from Nance for 8 points, 35-10, and a beautiful fill. Not often we see beautiful Stanton fills like that. So that was nice for 6 points. Whistler playing up at the net, throws the rope at though, but Nance is not fooled. Oh, and on the miss side, the one hopper gets points, 53-10. So Nance getting off to a quick dominant first set, looking to continue that. Whistler looking to stop the bleeding. And the nice post shot from Nance gets 12 points. Nance has been on a roll tonight, taking out No Name of all people, the number one ranked SR player, and then beating WeDie. Now he's looking for his hat trick against Whistler. 11 points goes to Whistler on that last rally, and 7 goes to Nance there on the shot to the left corner. Down the line from Whistler, Nance slides, does get it, does have the back line. Whistler unfortunately losing juice, but both players building it a back up. Nance looking like he was trying to predict a shot, and Whistler throwing a nice knuckleball to the corner, gets the points. 24-19, 6 points for Whistler, 30-19. Nance might be getting a little greedy on the... he's getting greedy, or he's playing, or he's messing around.
Thank you for messing with me.
8-19. Back lob from Whistler. Mance catches it. He has just forced the slide on the short hop.
Oh,
just missed. I do not know how that missed. Looked like Whistler turned at the last second and did not catch it. Short hop from Mance, caught by Whistler with the long slide. And unfortunately, with the new system, that can punish Stanton quite a bit, where he has very long slide motion. If you catch it right away, you're pretty much throwing white or no trail. So that's an unfortunate inadvertent nerf that happened to Stanton. 54-38 Nance does take it. And that is MJ Nance's hat trick.
I just realized I haven't played in a week. I grabbed my controller. You guys can see this. But there's something going on with my controller. The sticks are like chewed up.
Oh, what?
I think the dog got a hold of this.
Oh, yeah. It looks like the dog did. Yeah. That is not good.
Not good. All right. Well, I'm afraid to try do anything with the bot. Let's see if it will actually advance the winner and give Nance his hat trick.
Nance says, I think the dog give you a run for your buddy.
Bad puppy.
Well, it's gonna be Q and Particle Man.
Yeah, it's actually gonna be Q and Particle Man. I'll fix that. We're not really keeping track of stats tonight, but it's Q and Particle Man.
Yeah.
DRW 6. It'll be corrected after this. So at least, I mean, as far as progressing the winner, that's working. I don't know why the skip is failing.
Particle Man.
Oh, wait a minute. Autonomous and I are up, actually. Sorry.
Oh, well,
I promised Autonomous. All right. Autonomous, DRW.
Particle Man, come watch with me. Oh, lobby closed.
Sorry about that, P-Man.
I was going to say, we could have just kept it and have
P-Man. Thomas, are you playing me or are you choosing another opponent? It doesn't matter. But I've got opened the room DRW.
DRW?
DRW.
Okay.
Q with the Jamillionaire. Nice.
Yeah.
I like it.
I can legit rock the Jamillionaire.
I saw that. I saw you had actually over 1 million Jamolians.
That's right. That is right.
Okay. Well, two can play that game.
You should have to have a Jamillion.
In order to equip it?
In order to use the attack, should only open up when you get a Jamillion. Oh. We're all Jamillionaires in our hearts.
Mm-hmm. I've earned over 1 million Jamillions.
Well, that's good enough.
Probably. I probably earned over 1 million. I have no clue.
Well, I'm sure you have.
Yeah, sure I've played since April of 2017, so.
Oh, I'm sure you have, man. You probably earned a million a couple of times.
And that's between both PC and PS4. Like, combined, probably. Mostly PS4.
So what we got autonomous. Uh-oh.
Really? I have to leave?
Yeah, oh. Sorry.
Oh. All right. Well, I'll. I'll take the mic back on this.
No. I can. One sec. Actually, I don't want to hold things up too long.
Well,
yeah,
fine.
Just do it. It's fine. I won't hold it up.
I'll hand it back. Get it back after this one, and you can call and make some fish.
Okay, that's good.
We can take turns.
I'm
Well, look at that. That was nice of Nance. Gifted a tier one sub to No Name.
I'm probably playing. I'm probably playing the next one, honestly.
Oh, okay.
I think I am. Wait, no, it would be you and P Man.
Okay. Well, whichever. So,
DJ Swee Rip.
I'll be force.
Is that you, No Name? So Rattled? I mean, Autonomous?
No, So Rattled. Yeah, So Rattled is Autonomous.
Now he's blowing.
Oh, MJ Nance with another gifting another tier one sub. Wow.
Okay, here comes all the subs.
Nance is showing the love tonight.
Yeah, it is the Christmas season right there. Santa.
I think we're ready.
Santa Nance.
For MJ Claus, if you prefer.
Oh, oh.
Santa Nance.
Damn it. I forgot to check which which map we're playing on. We're going old school.
MJ Claus, yeah, that works too. So we got Whistler in red, and So Rattled or Autonomous. I'm just going to call him Autonomous in blue. Nice post shot. And the post right off the pole is going to answer with another one. So just a couple of post shots are exchanging back and forth. The blue knight's filtered. Watch the slide to get underneath it, underneath the lob here. And Autonomous is going to wall skip it down. A little short hop that ends up right in the middle of the court. Probably not what Whistler wanted. Going to filter that from the middle. Pretty easy to get to for Autonomous. Autonomous is juiced, but didn't want to give it up. Got greedy. Then dropped 15 points because of it. Pretty decent throw there. Thought Autonomous was going to get to it, but he just kind of let up at the end.
Dance with another sub. Look at that, my winning percentage.
Nobody saw that.
I love when they show that.
Don't anybody, I don't know, clip that. Nobody clip that for anything. So Whistler's going to get on that. He's going to get juiced. Get 12 points up for grabs here. He's going to wall skip it, though. He lost his juice. He's going to short hop this across, forcing Autonomous to slide. He's going to try to slide back on this post shot. He does a nice post shot. Gets the front half of the first panel, and it's in there. So a really nice shot there by Autonomous. Whistler could not even with the backslide, he couldn't get to it. He's going to lob Autonomous back row. Nice throw. Whistler slides through and cuts it off. Autonomous cuts that one off. Whistler cuts off a straight throw down the sideline. So a little bit of sliding going on. Playing the defensive game. Autonomous, a little hiccup it looks like, but he's moving around pretty good at the moment. Still throw that kind of drifts off into the middle. Ooh, a skinny hop. Whistler has to slide for that. That might have caught him by surprise. Nice post shot. Right at the back, right at the front of the first panel.
Nice gets one.
Yeah, nice of mix up of shot selection there. I thought Autonomous did a good job of moving Whistler around. And then finishes him off with a nice throw. Skinny hop, Whistler's gonna pop this up, get a little inside the hash. Gonna go, Autonomous goes aggro on it. Whistler slides, pick it up, lobbing to the back. So Autonomous gets underneath it. What's he gonna do with it? Straight down the sideline, Whistler's got it. Purple throw, couple of purple throws. Oh, he lost his juice on that one, so Autonomous has to restart, but it ain't gonna make a difference. He tries to get back and then gets a little bit out of position and can't get up on that pocket shot from Whistler, and that's going to be 43-28. So Whistler's trying to claw himself back into this, and we'll see if he can do it. Oh, he gets bonked on his defensive slide. Get bonked on a defensive slide, and Whistler, man, he's right back into this one. First set's looking good.
Oh.
So straight down the sideline, and that's a nice throw by Autonomous. Whistler trying to recenter.
Get bonked, son.
Can't squint back over there. So here we go. Wall skip. Whistler slides for that. It's going to lob Autonomous back to the back. Nice skinny, kind of slow, wide skinny hop there. Another one. Whistler's going to get to both of those, trying to get Autonomous moving around. But Autonomous gets into a nice position, front half of the court. It's a hop right in the side corner there. So nice choice. When he gets a skimmer off the sidewall, and that's tough to read. Tough to read, especially from a semi-aggro position Whistler was in. That's going to be tough to get to. Whistler's going to throw a white right in the middle, so he's going to give Autonomous a chance to really get going here. So if he can move him around, and he's doing it. Whistler has to slide for that throw. It's going to lob. It's going to get underneath Autonomous. He's going to short hop this, but it turns into a ricochet. Slide, aggressive slide through by Whistler. Ends up throwing a white, of course, with the new slide through mechanic. Or the new timer. That kind of hurts those long slide throughs. And nice post shot there by Autonomous. Had a little bit of filth, a little bit of curve, kind of a filth, more of a post. It's right on the panel, and that's where it needed to be. So Autonomous is flirting now with a jam. See what he can do with it. This time Whistler's going to long slide. Going to throw another white after. Gotta watch those long slides.
There we
nowadays.
Go. Put away that jam command.
But one thing for sure, Whistler is not going to get jammed. So he averted that deal. So short hop. Autonomous slides through on that. Throws a blue. There's a short hop again. And Autonomous slides again. It was a blue wall skip. It just sneaks by.
Oh, greedy.
And Autonomous up 47-13. pop this one up, go to the hash. Phil throw whistler cuts it off. Nice Phil throw by him up. It was more of a post throw, really. And of course, Autonomous move around now. Now Whistler looks like he's kind of in control of the court. Autonomous has to slide a couple of times. Whistler's juice, what's he going to do with it? Throws it down the sideline. He's got 17 points on this rally. Short hop loses his juice, but he didn't need it. It was a well-placed shot, and he doubles his points, basically. It's 47-30, so Whistler's trying to close him back in. Oh, he got up into a good aggro position. And,
I don't know what happened.
Just misjudged the disc coming off the wall. It was a good game by Autonomous. Some nice rallies.
Good games. All right, Q, you and P-Man are up.
Oh, me and P-Man. Okay.
Yeah, that's only my second game since last week. And once I get this stuff done for the new year, I'll back to practicing again. Although I still have a problem with the game. I don't know if you noticed, but I got this screen tear going, and I don't know if I'm going to reinstall it or what. I'm not sure. Terrible frame rate. Where were we? Beast, you're a funny guy.
Hmm?
Oh, I just saw your messages.
Oh, yeah, my comment. Yeah. That's a good emote.
What room are we? DRW 6.
6,
E-Man is blue, Q's red, I go spectator. Beach is doing the play-by-play. We are ready. Penthouse is selected. Let's do this.
Okay, we have Q-Sec with Gator on the blue side. We got Particle Man with Stanton on the blue. I think I mixed that up, but whatever. Particle Man on juice gets 11 points. A very common point amount. First possible juice throw happens at 11. And Q responds with an ace of his own. We got building up a juice. Particle Man getting a little aggro there. But, oh, he Clubs up starting a perfect set. Looks like Q will have advantage. But Particle Man on the well-placed short hop does get the points, 24-10 in favor of Particle Man. Down the line, for wall ride from Particle Man. Cross court filth from Q. Some nice filth shots coming out of Q there. It looked like the accidental front lock came out. That looked just kind of weird. One hopper from Particle Man gets points. I believe that is 24, something very high. 42-10 in favor of Particle Man. Short hop from Particle Man. Down, straight shot from Q. Q catches the wall ride. Down the line from Particle Man, and Q cannot get it. 56-10 for this first set. So looking to the next set, I think it could do Q a little bit better to begin to maybe either sit back a little bit and work towards aggro or go full aggressive. Particle Man doesn't always handle aggression the best, although Particle Man himself not afraid to go aggressive. 11 points there for Particle Man, 11-9 the score in the set. Particle Man sliding to catch that serve from Q. The knuckleball serves tend to fool a lot of people. Oh! And P-Man eating a bomb. 18-11. P-Man playing up on midcourt. That's down the line, it's 11 points there, 22 to 18 in favor of Parkman as he takes the lead again in this set. 28 to 18 on the 6 points. Got ourselves a quick six from Kumo. Both players on juice now. Q-Sec throws juice first, short hop, caught, return as a straight shot. We got a wall hop. Oh, Q gets caught right inside the hopping zone on that one. 42 to 18 in favor of Q, or in favor of Parkman. As Q gets aggressive, throws the post shot, but Parkman able to slide catch it. Turned back as a blue from Parkman now. Oh, Q losing juice. Unfortunate, throws the wall to P-Man. Also sides to both players. But nothing. Looks like Q was about to be juiced, but had to do a slide through on that. Blue throws back and forth. Will we see another pink throw in this rally? We do. Parkman gets it right there. He went with the skinny knuckleball. Down the line for Parkman. Short hop from Q. Forces Parkman off juice, but Parkman forces Q off juice right away. Short hop from Q. Oh, and he wins the set on the knuckleball. The skinny knuckleball. 52-40, 53-42. Q picks up the set. Wall ride from part of command. Down the line from Q off of a white throw. Both players looking to build up their juice again. One for part of command, one for Q. Two for part of command. Q down the line. Both players kind of playing down the line. Short hop from part of command. Short hop return in return from Q. Both players forcing each other to slide wall ride from Particle Man. He has Q sliding, but Q gets aggressive and forces P-Man to slide on a beautiful knuckleball. Particle Man catching the ball at the disc at the net. Oh, but Q with the return throw. Just out of Particle Man's reach. 26 to nothing. So it seems like that's something that Q has to do. He can just keep Particle Man off his toes with stuff like... I guess he did throw a short lob there, and it did end up with points for him, and so we get 16 more points for Q, 42 to nothing. Are we gonna get a jam, or will P-Man save little Parkman get points in this set? Winner of this set does take the match and move on. Both players sliding around throwing juice. We got a one from Q, and Parkman on the short hop of his own gets points. So it's 19 to 42 now. Parkman gonna have to slowly claw his way back. He is right, and he gets some points right there. 42 to 29 as ball just gets out of the reach of Q's slide. Short hop from Parkman. Post shot from Q. Parkman forces Q back with a back lob. Slides for the disc. Maybe an unnecessary slide, but Parkman with the slide through. Does throw to the post, but Q able to grab it. And the short hop from Parkman takes the lead. 45-42, ladies and gentlemen. We are about to have a pseudo jam. Down the line from Q. Cross from Particle Man off the slide. Down the line, does get it. 42.
Wow.
59. That was a very intense set. Particle Man fighting back from 42 to nothing to win the set.
Good game. It's Princess Stanton.
Princess Particle Princess Man. Princess Stanton. That was a fantastic game.
For the win.
That was great. Down the line from Q. Cross from Particle Man off the slide. Down the line. Oh, does
that was
get
some
it.
Comeback.
42.
Wow.
59. That was a very intense set. Particle Man fighting back from that. 42 to nothing to win the set.
Yeah, that was a fun game. That was.
Oh my goodness.
It's interesting when they're streaky like that, when you see runs by both players.
Yeah, it's quite intense. It's my turn. Go Particle Man.
All right.
All right, Fish, you are up.
All right.
You and Q are just tag teaming the play-by-play. I like it.
We got it covered.
Dun, 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 dun. I noticed no new song in the patch.
Oh,
no new music.
True. Now, is there just the three different tunes? three different variations of the tune, I think. So yeah, I don't remember. I haven't noticed anything new. You're right.
Guess they nailed it on the first try.
That's right. Why mess with perfection, right? Oh, I did, no name. I did. I certainly wasn't part of my plan, but it just happened.
All right, P-Man going for two in a row. Fish is in. Hugh's in. I'm in. Spectators are in.
That was a heck of a run, P-Man. Good job.
He's ready to go.
So we're gonna have
Princess versus the Jamillionaire. You know, that's a good matchup there.
Yep, it is. I think both of them are pretty happy with that arrangement, right? In most cases, right?
Princess would always be happy with that arrangement.
Absolutely. So we're gonna see purple. Oh man,
I
red.
Forgot to check the stupid
court.
I don't know what court we're going to get. It's going to be random.
Oh, we got the new one. We got Fish in blue, Particle Man in red. Fish will be playing Gator. Particle Man, as always, will be Stanton. So,
I think he might have a better win percentage than I do with Stanton. Maybe.
I think maybe everybody.
Everybody.
Everybody. Probably does. But that's neither here nor there. That Fish is gonna get juicy. It goes aggro, ends up having to slide, but with a really good post shot. That thing ended up right where he needed it to be, so even though it was blue, it was good enough. A couple of post shots just back and forth. There's a skinny hop. Particle Man catches it on the bounce. Another one that was off the third panel. Now they're both juicy. We got 13. Oh, 12. 12 on the rally. So he's gonna get off of that short hop into the post. So nice shot there by Fish. He's gonna get behind this one. Particle Man has to slide for that straight through down the sideline. He's going to post across. Particle Man slides up. He's going to go aggro on him. Skinny hop from that aggro position. And he's going to get in there. It's going to sneak by Fish. 18 to 23. That's a backslide really hard. And he decides to just go ahead and lob Fish back there. Like just a plain old hop throw straight down the sideline. So Fish is a couple of basic throws here. Now he's going to drop his juice. So it seems like he's a little bit off here on his throws, but he's gonna slide through to get to that nice skimmer down the sideline, and there's a good short hop from Particle Man. Juiced. Stanton juice throwing short hops is real dangerous. Hard to read those sometimes. Wall skip, blue, gonna answer with a purple wall skip from Fish. Post shot across, Fish has got that clean. Now he's juiced. Gonna have 11 on the round. Oh, he can't get it to return it. Just straight down the sideline, and it just sneaks by him. Wow. What a surprise there. Fish has to slide hard for this one, so he's going to lob Particle Man to the back. Just a plain hop straight on the sideline. There's a skinny hop. Particle Man slides for it. Goes with a nice fill throw. Play Fish has to slide. Particle Man's working on his juice. Got 15 on the clock here. Particle Man needs one more throw to get juiced. Now we're up to 18. What's he going to do with this 20-point rally he's got going on here? Another post shot. There's this wall skip. Fish has to slide for it. Short hop. Particle Man has to slide for it, so they're both going to start rebuilding juice. 25 on the rally. Another post shot goes off the second panel straight on the sideline. Fish slides. Skinny hop. Particle Man gets behind it. Short hop, and that's going to do it. Particle Man finishes him off. A really great rally to finish that set.
Is that 72 points?
Yeah, who's up there? 72, something like that? So there's a quick curve that Particle Man slide for. Wall skip, another wall skip. Fish is under this. Short hop's going to rickshaw him back, turn into kind of a pocket shot. There's a post shot. Particle Man slide for it. It was a good one. The second, third panel throw there. And a nice juiced hop throw from Fish. Whew, that skinny hop was hard, and it was perfect. Particle Man can't reach it because it was juiced. So Fish showing off some nice juice throws here. Now we're going to might see some more, but no, Particle Man has to slide for this one, so Fish is just going to go with the wall skip. Particle Man has to slide for it. It's really shallow skinny hop. Oh my gosh, Fish, with, I don't know if that was the throwing ball or what that was, but he lost his juice, went to throwing a white. So they're working on rebuilding again. Short hop, Particle Man's on that. Straight throw, and there's another nice post shot. Goes skims off the first panel, and Particle Man gets to another nice fill throw. Particle Man has to slide, and there's a wall skip. Particle Man's not going to be able to slide into that one. A series of really nice throws there by Fish with the juice. And Fish Particle Man off, so we might want to get that jam command ready if Fish can get juiced again in this one. You're gonna slide to get under that hop throw. It's gonna lock up from the end of the back, straight throw down the side, really, really shallow, skinny hop, really. And post shot, kind of skimming along there. There's a nice field throw, but Prodigal comes on it pretty easily, and he's juiced. Beast is juiced, 15 on the rally. He's gonna go across everybody. It's a third panel. I don't know if Prodigal Man needs to slide for it, but he does anyway, and ends up decent field throw going back across, and he's got 17 points, so you can put the jam command away, because that's not gonna happen right here. Short hop, bounces off both walls, is easily gotten by Prodigal Man. Prodigal Man slides up on the skinny hop, really wanted to slide up and get into a more aggressive mode. He probably could have fielded that one cleanly, but he wanted to get up. He wants to get a blue, wants to throw a blue from closer to the net. He really feels like apparently that's gonna be a weakness that Beach has got right now, and he's really trying to exploit it. Now, Prodigal Man slides to get under this one. Beast is juiced. What can he do with it? A skinny hop that goes, or a short hop that goes right down the middle. There's a nice ball skip juiced.
Thought he was
that's
there.
Gonna finish this one. Yeah, that's going to finish this one. Beast working those juiced throws like he's known to do. That's a really weird play. I don't know if that was a throwing bug. Got him off to a white start, but we're going to see if he can recover from that situation. He's not going to be able to on that nice hard hop throw from Beast. It skims right by him, kind of stuck in that hop zone. All right, so Fish with a pretty nice hop throw there, kind of a post hop, wall skip. There's a wall skip answer. Fish has to slide for it, so he's throwing a blue. Prodigal Man's working on Billy's juice. That's a slide for that wall skip. There's a post short hop that goes to a post on the second panel. Another one's going to go off the second panel. Nice field throw, and ends up skimming off the second panel. And Prodigal Man's under that. Oh, there he goes. Prodigal Man's a slide for that nice hop throw. He's going to short hop that, and that's it on the post. 32-0, Fish. Beach out to a big early lead on that. That's a large rally. Prodigal Man wants to see if he can get something going here, and he's going to go hard aggro. He's hard aggro, and he's not going to walk off of it. He's not backing off this time. He's going to see if he can use Particle that patented Prodigal Man slide and leverage just for some points, and he actually is able to do so with a good blue throw into the post. So, let's see if he keeps trying to do that. It looks like he wants to keep doing it. Blue throw into the post. Beach has got it. He's juiced. Ball skip. Beach is still juiced. Now Prodigal Man's going to back off on the full juice. The walls get this juice. Prodigal Man to slide for it. Short hop over to the second panel. Beast gets pretty easily answers with a nice hard skinny hop. That's gonna net him real close to finishing this one. 47-11. All Beast got to do win one more rally. Prodigal Man's got to claw his way out of a little bit of a hole here. Wall skip. Short hop. Prodigal Man slides for it. So he's throwing blues again. Beast came up to more of an aggressive position than a defensive slide. Lost his juice. So let's see if Prodigal Man can take the advantage now. He's got two built. Now he's going to be juiced on this third throw. That didn't even need it. That was a nice hop throw right under the post. Getting 17 more points, I think it was, wasn't it?
Yeah.
The Prodigal Man's going to get under this lob here. Nice field throw by Fish. Forces a slide. Dirt Fish is going to go to the net this time. Then he backs off. So now Fish is juiced. Prodigal Man's working on building his. He's got 15 on the rally. Short hop. A little hard, though. Prodigal Man gets to it pretty easily. Now a nice field throw. Goes up the second panel. Prodigal Man gets to it. Throws a white throw on a long slide. Another pretty long slider, but he does get the blue out of it. Short hop. Prodigal Man slides for that. Nice seeing some P-Man defense on the baseline. This is what he's known for. Been doing it for a long time. So, Beach is working on getting juicy. Defense, big defensive slide right down the middle with a beautiful throw from Prodigal Man. Beach keeps this rally alive.
Oh!
And there's a nice post. There he goes. Goes aggressive on it. Goes post shot and gets a buy. What a nice rally. Some great defense there by the two players.
That was P-Man finally got Fish to slide, give up the juice, almost got himself in position to win that rally. That was close. Almost made that comeback real.
Yeah,
good game, guys.
That was a nice last rally there. They had a couple of really long rallies in that one. Those are when it gets tense and you start sweating. Get those long 20-point rallies going. Those are so stressful to play in.
Oh, gosh.
They're so much fun to watch. They're so much fun to watch, but no, they're so stressful to play.
Nance pulled off the upset.
I had to be really, really close to... I had to really look at the points to realize that if I didn't slide for that at 22... Like, I was going to lose, because I noticed that was when it hit the threshold. I was like, oh, no, I'm going to lose.
I have a feeling No Name is itching to get back in on the court and get a win, because he got upset his first time up, and he's been waiting there, tapping his foot, buying his time. He wants back in. Okay.
Now he knows what it's like for the rest of us.
Yeah.
A lot of times the rest of us only get one game, no. Then we have to sit back down. You're not used to that, but
yeah. Okay.
Now you got this, Fish.
Match settings, penthouse. Man says he's ready for the rematch, if it comes. Who's on deck?
It's Q.
You already? And then Nance, and then myself. Yeah,
I'm probably gonna take off. After
I'm safe.
It's getting late.
DRW8.
DRW8.
So yeah. Whenever I finish up, whether it's this one or I go
okay.
on.
Sounds good.
Sounds good.
Appreciate you coming out.
Yeah, appreciate
thanks
it,
for jumping in and doing some play-by-play.
Yeah, no problem.
Well, we thought he'd be ready.
No, normally name's ready. He must still be rattled after that last match.
Yeah, maybe.
What did you do,
maybe.
Nance?
Yeah, maybe what he's doing. He's in free play right now, practicing. So. We gotta get him out of free play.
This whole time. He's
trying to get a couple of reps in before.
He's on the stationary, keeping his legs warmed up.
Yep.
And that cardio, there we go. All right, let's start this.
Did I see that right? Are we seeing the big man in this one?
Did he give up on Lanny?
Thought I saw. He is.
Oh, we got a mirror match.
It's a Kahuna v Kahuna. We got a mirror match. So here we go. Fish with the slides and wall skip that blue. Short hop. There's off two walls. Fish gets to that. Nice short hop there by Fish. When I does feel it cleanly, and he's juiced now. And a nice short hop answer by himself. It's going to bounce all right off that first panel. That's in. So juice throw, Noname gets up on it, nice slide there, and Nance, just a nice quick throw there on the second panel, but Fish was in an aggressive position, so it ended up being perfect. Getting back around behind him. Fish slides, gonna lob Noname over into the long lob, and wall skip's gonna get just sneak right by him. God, that big guy's just a little slow. And a nice slide there by Fish, time that just right and gets to that throw, and wall skip, there's a still throw that ends up off the third panel, and that's a nice throw. They're gonna end up another one from Noname that ends up right on the first panel, right along the post. So that's another good throw by Noname. Wall skip, Noname slides to get that. Skinny hop. And a post shot, and that's going to get by. Nice throw there by Fish.
So greedy.
37-9. Fish is trying to get something going. He's not going to get jammed for sure. So we've established that. Excuse me. There's a saw blade super, and that's going to be hard to get to for even with the improved slide. I don't see Kahuna getting to that. And yeah, it looks like maybe just Kahuna's speed working against Fish on that one. I think maybe, you know, he's not used to playing that guy. He's a step slower. So, but Fish is going to get juiced, but he's going to have to use one of his slides. But he does keep his juice, but decides to throw a lob instead. Saw blade answer after Noname got under that long enough to charge it. It was an interesting choice there to lob back. I mean, I don't know if that was an accidental lob. I'm assuming it was. A nice post shot there by Noname. Noname at the net, playing super aggressive with that strong blue throw from Kahuna, and it's working for him so far. Nice knuckleball there right off the serve. Fish is going to have to get under this lob, and there's a big curve. He does get to it, though, and he's going to start building his juice up. As he gets lobbed to the back, Fish is going to filth throw this right at the first panel. Noname has to slide, so he's going to lob it. Fish gets underneath it, straight down the sideline. Fish is juiced. He's going to go right to the front lob, and it's going to work. That was really close. I thought Fish was going to make it there for a second, but that front lob gets to him. I guess he just had his feet a little too far back into the end zone. Short hop, perfect short hop right there, and that's going to get Fish on the board. See if he does it again. No, he's going to go straight on the sideline this time. There's a short hop. Fish has to slide for it. Really weird, hard, popping curve. Noname steps up into it and just throws a purple throw. Gets that purple throw right along the wall there. There's another hop throw right at the second panel. Those have been working for him. If you step up against that, he's going to quick curve around you. Even with Kahuna, he's not afraid to throw that quick curve from that net position. And it worked for him there. So 51-7. Noname puts that one away relatively quickly. But the Kahuna v. Kahuna matchup is a weird one. We've seen Noname play Kahuna a little bit. I don't know that I've seen Fish play Kahuna as much. So, I don't know. I'm not sure if that was even a factor or not.
But I think thanks a lot, Fish, for coming out. Thanks a lot for lending your voice to the channel again. Appreciate it.
Yep, Fish leaves the arena. Three wins, only two losses. I think that's good.
And I think MJ Nance was curious in chat. I think he was asking that about what something? Happens once we get. Well, I think he was asking what happens when we get down to. Do we keep doing King of the Court? And I don't think normally we don't.
No, we don't. We might mess around with some doubles if you guys want to. We do that sometimes, and
yeah, sometimes we'll wrap the channel up, or we'll just do random doubles and just see what happens, or just assign doubles depending on the SR differences of the four remaining people. So
yeah.
Is that where we're at the moment? Or no, I guess
we're
next.
Five.
Is that where we're at five? Okay, cool.
Yeah. Myself, you, No Name, and Nance.
My dub's SR isn't that
they
bad.
Are Q, No Name, Whistler, Q, and so you're in there twice somehow. There's only four of us. I don't know why you're in there twice. The bot was going bonkers earlier.
The bot loves me. I think that's what it's saying.
I'm wondering why he came up so quick.
Let me see what happens if I leave.
To go do it again. You're still in, probably. Took out one of you.
Yeah, that's kind of what I figured. It. Okay.
There we go.
Well, do we want to do some doubles? Do we want to give No Name a chance to finish?
Let's let No Name finish his run. Okay. And then if you guys want to do some doubles.
Okay. We'll I'll be down that. For a couple. If MJ Nance wants to. And No Name.
Definitely want to see a rematch between No Name and Nance.
Yeah, this should be good. I didn't get to see the first one, so.
What time is it?
I have to go back and check out the VOD.
It's 11 o'clock already?
No. Yeah, you've been going a couple hours
already.
We usually go
a couple hours?
Yeah, we usually go between two and a half hours.
Two and a half.
So. I remember though, because that one night we had 13 jammers in the queue.
Oh, I think we went 4 hours that night.
It was 1 o'clock in the morning.
Oh, yeah.
Before we quit playing.
Oh my God.
That was so much fun.
Well, it was 13 at one time, and we had 17 people enter the arena throughout the night.
That night? Oh, yeah. Yeah, there was always a ton of people in, and the games were just going and going.
I'm hoping this Mortal Jam thing might pique some more interest. Come in.
Oh, you want to? Are you saying you want to hop in the Discord whenever we do? If we decide to dub?
Yeah.
I don't think that's a problem.
No.
But for right now, it is you and No Name, mano a mano. We'll give No Name a chance to make a run for another hat trick before we finish King of the Court, I think. But it is you that is up to this point. He's
still going with the dead bot name.
Oh, sweet. Well, at least he didn't change it to keep that offer.
Are you joining?
There's two of me. Oh, am I? Yes, I am. Sorry.
DRW9.
So busy.
Match settings, pentals.
Looks like No Name's gonna stick with Kahuna?
Sticking with Kahuna.
Oh man. Here we go.
Oops.
No Name's dropping. He's got this. Patented, I got this. So the more things change, the more they stay the same. Post shot. That's a purple post shot from No Name, and that one's past him already. 6 points right out of the gate. Skinny hop. There's a short hop. No Name's under that skinny hop. A short hop that kind of drifts right in the middle. Probably not with the MJ is under that. Name's pissing me up now. Snack short hop that goes up the second panel and he's juice, and that's what got him those points. So MJ's going to get under this. He's going to wall skip that down. Straight on the sideline. That's a slide. MJ slide for it. Skinny hop is blue, but it was a good one. And that forced No Name to slide. There's a short lob. No Name's going to get under this. Greedy style. Didn't want to give up the juice, and it worked.
Oh.
And there's a nice hop throw by MJ. MJ moving around real well right with his gator.
hop throw, short hop. No name's gonna cut that off. And another short hop, no name has to slide for that. Another wall skip. MJ's gonna pop the sub, he's gonna throw MJ's water. No name's on that. Wall skip juice, and that's gonna get right by him. Big old slow dude. He just could not get over there fast enough. Hop right off the pole, down the sideline. MJ is hard to net with this stuff.
Did somebody just stuff no name?
It happens.
It's usually the other way around.
It does happen on occasion. Short hop right down the middle, but it's pretty easily filled by No Name. MJ's got juice, but he has to slide for that hard skinny hop. Now, No Name is juiced. Hard hop. No Name decides to slide for that one. I'm not sure if he needed to, but he thought it was necessary. There's the Pythagoras. He's going to drop it out. Oh, No Name just ran by it.
Just missed it.
He's going to drop that one 61-6. So No Name on the losing side of that set. And MJ on a roll right now. Wall skip, short hop. MJ's on that. Hop throw. He can answer with a quick curve, and he's on that one. Nice fill. Little tricky fill throw there.
Yeah.
Technically, I guess that's a fill.
I was with No Name on that one. Thought it was coming back towards him.
Yeah, it's kind of a weird one because it's technically it's pulling away from the wall, right? So it's a fill, but it's kind of a skinny one. A skinny fill, which you don't see a lot of. So short hop right at the first post, man. And MJ really confident on a short slide. It's stopped that slide perfectly. But a really nice hop throw there from No Name. And that is 15-10 now. So fill throw, No Name's on that, skinny hop. Another skinny hop. Right at the net with a wall skip. No Name pops it up and he's juiced. It's gonna go hard against that net side wall, right where the wall and the net meet. And to be honest, I thought MJ was in a pretty good position there to take that, but it just got by him. Slide straight down the sideline. Another one, pink purple throw straight down the sideline. There's the lob. Gonna slide up on that easily. And skimmer right off the wall there. Really nice throw choice by MJ. And that worked out really well for him. And there's a fill throw. No Name has to slide for a short hop. Gonna get on that. Another short slide there. There's a really smart and clever positioning here by MJ.
He's sliding over the lead.
Yeah, he's predicting where these throws are going with such accuracy that he's able to short slide, get it right to that spot, and hop up. Really impressive reading of the disc, I think, by MJ. There's a nice fill throw there too. It's 41-27. So,
yeah, No Name lost the juice somehow. It's not that's rare.
Yeah, yeah. When he doesn't have to slide, he'll usually keep it. So purple down the sideline is going to pop this up. Now he's going to get juice. Short hop. No Name's going to get to that clean. Pop this up to right where the hash is. Nice hop throw. Blue throw there, and now he's going to post shot that juice straight in the corner. And this thing is tied in the second set. So MJ is winning. MJ wants to put this away right here. Oh, and he tries to do that short hop. Tries to read that. Tries to play that same kind of reading style and short slide. This time he comes up a little short and ends up missing the disc. So hop throw, short. Nice hop throw. Nice skinny hop, I should say, right there. And that's going to finish it off. Both guys juiced there at the end, so that was just a really good rally. First one the guys juiced throw in was the one that won it, and that's what you like to see. That was a really good back and forth. And No Name's going to dance the night away.
Good game, Nance.
Yeah, good game, MJ. That was a really good game.
I don't think I've ever seen anybody go 2-0 against No Name.
No, I don't think it's ever happened.
All right, so let's give... That's not win. You guys want to do some doubles?
Kind of sounds like that's the direction we're going.
I think we might want to split Nance and No Name up.
Yeah, I think so.
You think so? I don't think we got a chance.
Yeah, why don't you and you want to go with No Name and Whistler?
Oh, No Name's done for the night.
Oh, No Name, you're done for the night? Well, hey, thanks for coming out, man. Thanks for the games. Thanks for all the weeks that you've come out and all the games that you've played. They've all been fun to watch. We really appreciate it. GG's for 6 months of great games.
Cool beans.
No, I think we'll probably wrap it up there then, I would think.
Yeah, I think so, and I might end the stream now, and I might hop on a little bit and play some Phantom Doctrine. I'll switch over and play some strategy games.
Yeah, I'll have to come back and check that out.
I was kind of getting into the KGB story there. I thought I was done with it until once I actually finally finished the CIA story, because that took so long, because I played it pretty much twice.
Right.
After restarting. Right. And I don't know, I guess I'm not ready to jump into anything else. So let me, I might do the KGB story.
Sounds good.
All right, buddy.
I may take a little break, and I may see you back on.
Yeah, I'll probably restart up in about 10-15 minutes.
Sounds good, man.
Good night, everybody.
Good night, everybody.
Have
Thanks
a happy
again.
New year too.
Yeah, if you're traveling or doing anything, drive careful.
Be
and,
safe.
No drinking and driving this weekend.
You're welcome, Nance. Yeah. I have to go get a new bot.